Hey guys, hope you're having a great day as well as a great life.
Okay, so pretty freaking cool news. We got an email last week, basically from the team from the Rolling Stones. So on their team, I guess some of their representatives reach out to say, hey, they really love the channel, and they wanted us to review for the 55th anniversary of the Rolling Stones, I Can't Get No Satisfaction. They wanted us to do a live video from Ireland.
Yeah, and it's apparently like when it first came out, I think it's like in 65, something like that, August 20th. All this crazy stuff, and apparently it's way heavier.
Yeah.
Way heavier than the studio version.
Yeah, so for the anniversary, it happened, I think, on the 20th, so the whole month they're doing a big push for that specific song. But I mean, when the Rolling Stones reach out to you, how can you say no?
Yeah, and I don't think we've heard any live Rolling Stones at all.
No, I don't think so.
At all.
So with that being said, we're really just going to get right into it. So I guess just know it's 55th anniversary. We're doing a special for them. Thanks for you guys for
reaching out.
Yeah, reaching out, making this happen. With that being said, let's get into it.
Wow, dude, that was way cool.
Yeah,
way cool.
I like it better in the studio version for sure. A little bit of sped up, I dig that. It gives more energy. I like that it was a little dirtier as far as the guitar tone and the drum tone. It wasn't recorded as cleanly. So yeah, liked it a lot.
Because when we did the studio version, it was my first time hearing you show it to me. My chief like complaint of it was that it felt so Beatles-esque in a way that if I wanted that feeling, I would just go listen to the Beatles instead.
Yeah.
This felt like not that. This like completely revamped, reworked the song, and just now I, you know, it just feels like unique to them.
A little bit. Because the studio version feeling. Is cool, but it's clean. This feels way more rock and roll.
Yeah, it's dirty, dude.
I dig that.
65 too, and then like the person reached out to us said, you know, they went pretty heavy in this song compared to the studio version, which they did. This felt way more just like hyped up, you know, feisty teenage angst.
I wonder if the case for that, if the reason why is because they didn't have as great of amplification systems back then,
so they needed more.
So they cranked the amps up, and you get more grit from cranking the amp. So I wonder if they just it was a consequence. They like I don't know if they went purposely like let's make this heavier, or if they just were like we have to crank this as loud as it goes so it just gets dirtier.
Yeah,
you know,
mixture that plus just the vibe of it. Like the singer was kind of just going nuts, dude.
Oh yeah,
he was like dancing with the microphone a little bit, dude.
Yeah, he's got the moves Jagger. Like literally Jagger. One of the things is interesting.
That's where that's from.
Yeah, one of the things Beryl, who's been on the channel, shout out to Beryl, told me when I told him we were gonna do this because they reached out to us.
Yeah.
He was like, well, do you know where the song came from? Now, this is from him, so if he's wrong, he's wrong. Barely suck. He said that Keith Richards woke up and heard the guitar line in a dream, woke up, like, played it on guitar, and he heard it as horns in his head. He thought it was going to be, like, horns. And so that's why he used fuzz guitar to, like, imitate that. So he, like, woke up, recorded himself playing that line, the da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
It literally sounds kind of like horns when you think about it, too.
So he heard horns in his dream. He decided to record it on guitar, and then they used fuzz to imitate the horns that he heard in his dream.
Dude, that is literally insane. I never thought about it like that. But like when you like even like when I think of the guitar line in my head now, it sounds like horns a little bit.
Yep,
that's ridiculous. Cool, and the fuzz really does do that.
It really does. It gives that like that gritty sound. Really great performance. I thought it was great.
It was phenomenal, and his voice sounds really good live.
Here's my only
go ahead.
I'm not sure. This easily could have been recorded at where they were doing it, but it's hard to tell. Because
it sounded almost too good quality
too good quality.
At least in terms of the vocals.
And also, there's a clap going on. There's somebody clapping, and it's not like unison clap of the crowd where it's like this big... It's very isolated, one guy clapping.
I wonder if they played over some kind of like track, maybe?
It's too early for that.
Maybe they took the footage, took the files or whatever of the recording, and then they like... produced it and they remastered it for this video.
That could have been it. Either way, very, very cleanly done. Sounded phenomenal. It really sounded impeccable. And I liked the clap in there, like having the guy clapping with it, because I think it added something to the song.
Yeah.
Love the energy. I mean, the energy was just, it was 100% there.
That's 65 too? Like, that's early.
That's all I could have wanted from watching this. So, 55th anniversary, go check them out. Give the song a listen to if you haven't listened to it in a while.
Absolutely. There's some links in the description for that for you guys.
Yeah. And with that being said, thank you guys again for the Stones team for reaching out. You guys have a wonderful day.